The four members of the Polaris Dawn crew are back on Earth after successfully performing the first commercial spacewalk. Paul Allen has been following the story, and there was a lot of focus on the spacewalk. But what were they sort of hoping to achieve, and did they manage to get there?
Yeah, they did. I mean, a lot of focus on this was, of course, yes, it's a spacewalk, first by private citizens. It was very exciting, looked like a joyride for a billionaire. But there was a lot of point to it as well. I mean, the old spacesuits that we're used to seeing and vision of the International Space Station, they're really bulky, they're uncomfortable, they have design flaws. So the intention was proof of concept for that. And in that respect, it was a big success. The designer of them calls them a suit of armour made of fabric that becomes rigid when pressurised. The visor has a heads-up display. Chris Trigg of SpaceX, who led the design of this, says the goal is to make it feel as if you're going about your business wearing everyday clothes. So, yeah, a big tick for that. This mission also reached a peak altitude of 1,400 kilometres above Earth, so only the Apollo moon missions have gone further than that. And there was a whole range of other experiments as well, including laser-based testing of communications between that capsule and the Starlink fleet of satellites.
But really something that we're watching is that it was really a commercial spacewalk, right? So what does this really mean for future missions?
Yes, it was a commercial spacewalk, and it was funded by billionaire Jared Isaacman, and it, you know, did have the feel of a stunt. But this was just the first of three Polaris Dawn missions. The next one has a rather vaguely defined goal to expand the boundaries of human spaceflight missions. But Mission 3 is where it gets really interesting. That will be the first human crewed flight of Starship, which is that giant reusable rocket that SpaceX is currently testing. The next test launch of that's probably looking at November. And this time SpaceX would attempt to catch that enormous booster with the launch tower. The ultimate goal of all of this is to have a permanent settlement on Mars, and that gets us back to the suit design. They're going to need a lot of them. They're going to need to be scalable to fit every shape and size of human beings. So this is just the first step, or, well, another small step, on a long, long road to eventually reach Mars.